I've been a big fan of music for as long as I can remember. I think I started getting exposed to sound through microphones, setting up a sound system in school. I used to ring the bell for every period. I don't know, I just loved that activity. There was just something about it. And I was reading magazines by then. And through friends, we found this magazine called Mix. And we started reading it, some of my friends and I. And we were totally fascinated. And on one side, we were listening to Bryan Adams' records, Michael Jackson's records. And now there was this magazine that was talking about how those records were done. And that's when I encountered Quincy Jones, Bruce Swedeen, Jerry Hay, and of course all the lovely instrumentalists who worked on those records. And I think there was an ad in one of those issues of Mix magazine. We take your dreams seriously. I was like, huh, you take my dreams seriously? I mean, how serious would this be? Cutting a long story short, coming straight to Full Sail, in the third month, I think there was a success seminar. And one of the speakers was coming in that year was Bruce Swedeen. I was like, wow, you know, isn't that something? I got the opportunity to ask a few questions to Bruce. And he was kind enough to answer all of them. I was like, he's talking about all this stuff. Won't people like Michael and Quincy have something to say about that? And he said, you know what, Ashish? There are no secrets. And it took me a really long time to understand that. The meeting with Bruce was very special early on in the course. I was informed that after the meet with Bruce that day, he mentioned me, I think, to Gary and to a couple of other instructors. He says that if you are free and if you can make it over Christmas, you could go and stay with them for a few days, you know, at his home. I was like, oh. So I could associate with Bruce, but there was no gig and there was no internship, as he would remind me every time. He set out like an ear training program for me. So he said, we're going to do some listening. He said, so you're going to be in New York City, you're okay staying there and doing this? I said, sure. Here I was with the master, but there's no gig, right? So I had to look for a gig. So I approached a lot of studios and I kind of found and met up with this company called Ephemeral Music. What I found out about them is that they do great work. You know, they had a lovely studio and they had great gear and great clients. At FNL, got to work with, again, some fantastic artists. I got to work at Avery Fisher Hall, at Alistair Lee Hall. Got to work with Wynton Marsalis, James Taylor. And then through them, of course, there was a gig with Garth Brooks. And he was doing a concert series in Dublin. When I came back to India around 2002, like full time to settle back, I was fortunate to have worked with some lovely artists and some lovely people. A few of our friends and other people said they wanted to make their records sound better and do something better. So I was like, I can share my experiences. We used to do weekend workshops. Then more people started enrolling. Now our course is a one-year course. This is our way of sharing what we know to the next set of people who are hungry for this information. At some point in our life, you need a mentor. You cannot figure out everything yourself. In some way, I see myself doing that for the people who, around us right now, where we are setting up a platform, essentially for the songwriters, young producers, young music makers, engineers. And I still remember when Bruce said that there are no secrets. There will be somebody, maybe even that one person, who would understand the gravity of what has been spoken or being shared. So I know that happened with me. And that makes it worth it. You know, whom you can connect with